rest recline. I love the name of Jesus,
Emmanuel, Christ the Lord,
my fragrance on the
breezes,
his name abroad is poured.
This is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. From the rising of the sun to its setting.
The name of the Lord is to be praised.
Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to
anger, and abounding in steadfast love, and repents of evil.
Jesus said, if any man would come after me, let him deny himself
and take up his cross and follow me.
Christ was wounded for our transgressions.
He was bruised for our iniquities.
From the rising of the sun to its setting,
the name of the Lord is to be praised.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. We read responsively by whole verses, Psalm 51. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercy, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin, for I know my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against you, you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight, so that you may be justified in your words and blameless in your judgment. Behold, I was brought forth in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Behold, you delight in truth in the inward being, and you teach me wisdom in the secret heart. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Let me hear joy and gladness. Let the bones that you have broken rejoice. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with a willing spirit. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be to forever. Amen. You may be seated. The Old Testament reading this evening is from 2 Kings chapter 5. Naaman, commander of the army of the king of Syria, was a great man with his master and in high favor, because by him the Lord had given victory to Syria. He was a mighty man of valor, but he was a leper. Now the Syrians, on one of their raids, had carried off a little girl from the land of Israel, and she worked in the service of Naaman's wife. She said to her mistress, "Would that my lord were with the prophet who is in Samaria. He would cure him of his leprosy." So Naaman went in and told his lord. Thus and so spoke the girl from the land of Israel. And the king of Syria said, "Go now, and I will send a letter to the king of Israel." So he went, taking with him 10 talents of silver, 6,000 shekels of gold, and 10 changes of clothes. And he brought the letter to the king of Israel, which read, "When this letter reaches you, know that I have sent to you Naaman, my servant, that you may cure him of his leprosy." When the king of Israel read the letter, he tore his clothes and said, "Am I God to kill and to make alive that this man sends word to me to cure a man of leprosy? Only consider and see how he is seeking a quarrel with me." But when Elisha, the man of God, heard that the king of Israel had torn his clothes, he sent to the king, saying, "Why have you torn your clothes? Let him come now to me, that he may know that there is a prophet in Israel." So Naaman came with his horses and chariots and stood at the door of Elisha's house. And Elisha sent a messenger to him, saying, "Go and wash in the Jordan 7 times, and your flesh shall be restored, and you shall be clean." But Naaman was angry and went away, saying, Behold, I thought that he would surely come out to me and stand and call upon the name of the Lord his God and wave his hand over the place and cure the leper. Are not Abana and Pharpar, the rivers of Damascus, better than all the waters of Israel? Could I not wash in them and be clean? So he turned and went away in a rage. But his servants came near and said to him, My father, it is a great word the prophet has spoken to you. Will you not do it? Has he actually said to you, Wash and be clean? So he went down and dipped himself 7 times in the Jordan, according to the word of the man of God, and his flesh was restored like the flesh of a little child, and he was clean. O Lord, have mercy on us. The epistle is from 1 Corinthians chapter 6. Do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived. Neither the sexually immoral, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor men who practice homosexuality, nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor swindlers will inherit the kingdom of God. And such were some of you, but you were washed, you were sanctified, you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand. The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 12th chapter. 6 days before the Passover, Jesus therefore came to Bethany, where Lazarus was, whom Jesus had raised from the dead. So they gave a dinner for him there. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those reclining with him at table. Mary, therefore, took a pound of expensive ointment made from pure nard and anointed the feet of Jesus and wiped his feet with her hair. The house was filled with the fragrance of the perfume. But Judas Iscariot, one of his disciples, he who was about to betray him, said, Why was this ointment not sold for 300 denarii and given to the poor? He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief, and having charge of the money bag, he used to help himself to what was put into it. Jesus said, Leave her alone, so that she may keep it for the day of my burial. The poor you always have with you, but you do not always have me. O Lord, have mercy on us. We have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He was delivered up to death.
He was delivered for the sins of the people.
Blessed is the one whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered.
He was delivered up to death. He was delivered for the sins of the people.
We have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He was delivered up to death. He was delivered for the sins of the people. We confess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. You take a diamond and hold it up to the light and turn it around, it refracts the light into many colors. It's quite an astonishing thing to behold, to be sure, and the best of the diamonds can produce the most amazing array of colors. We're going to sort of do that this Lenten season, holding up forgiveness to the light and seeing its many colors, its beauty. It's good to do that from time to time. Because of the fact that forgiveness is mentioned so often in the church, perhaps we forget just how beautiful it really is, how astonishing the fact that God forgives your sins completely for Jesus' sake is. We take it too often for granted, I think. And it really is the most precious jewel forgiveness is that the church has. The facet tonight, the facet of forgiveness we'll consider is perhaps the most natural of those images, and certainly one of the most well-known. Perhaps you caught the theme a little bit in what we sang and in the psalm that we shared together, and even with the readings, the facet of cleansing or washing. It's one of the most natural images because, at least, I don't know about you, but for me, cleansing becomes an important thing. I'm going to go off script for a little bit and tell you about what happened at our house today. Woke up this morning, it was cold. Propane was out. Okay, no big deal. We thought we were on the automatic refill thing. Well, we weren't, so we called the Tri-Gas, and they came out about noon to fill it up. Well, everybody was gone. Philip and Leslie were both at work. Kids were at school. It was just me and the dogs. And the dogs, they don't care, but it was only about 50 degrees in the house. They just huddled up. So anyway, I'm trying to get things ready for tonight, and I turn on my computer. No computer. It's deader than a doornail. Well, that was not so good. So I figured, well, I guess I'll just have to see how long it's going to take for the Tri-Gas to come out and fill. And this was about 8:30, 9 o'clock. Noon, they come out, no problem, filled it up, took off. I went downstairs, turned on the furnace. Of course, the motor went to go turn on the water heater. Couldn't get the blooming thing going. And I'm thinking to myself, well, I hope I get this going soon because I want to at least be able to take a shower before I go to church tonight, especially since we're talking about being clean. They don't need a pastor who's going to come in dirty. Well, to no avail. The furnace was running, but I kept looking at the thermostat and it didn't go up. It got up to about 60 degrees and then it stayed there. So I called my son-in-law up. I don't fix anything. If it's broken at the house, don't ask me. I can't help you. But Philip can fix most anything. So I called him up. He's at work. And he said, did you check this? Did you check that? And I said, yeah. He said, well, go down and punch that button again. So I did. No, nothing. Didn't get any warmer. What do you got any ideas about the water heater? He said, you read the instructions. I said, yeah, I can do that. But to no avail. So it gets to be about 2 o'clock. And I decided, well, the dogs need to go out again, so I'll take the garbage and we'll go outside, throw it in the dumpster out there, go outside with the dogs, take the trash out, and there is an envelope from Tri-Gas laying on the side by the garage door. And they must have hooked it on the door, you know, and that didn't stay on there because of the wind. Pick up, it says, gas turned off at the tank. So they filled it, but turned the gas off at the tank. So no wonder I couldn't get anything started. There's no gas coming to the house. So here it's 2:30. Go in, furnace comes on, starts to have heat come out. Water heater starts right away. Now I've got to decide, because I had already put a pan on the stove, big pan of water, thinking I can put that in the sink after it gets hot and get clean that way. I'll risk it. But waited until about 3:20. Got in the shower. It was kind of lukewarm, but I got clean. Do you have a problem with cleanliness in your house? Anybody have any problem with cleanliness tonight as you ate chili? Anything drop? The problem with chili stains, mustard stains, ketchup stains is they're not easy to get out, are they? You can't rub them. What is it, club soda? Salt, something like that, you're supposed to be able to put on those kinds of things to get it out. I'm thinking about Carolyn Ruck. You know who she is. She's had a nice little baby we're going to baptize this Sunday, aren't we? I'm sure that there's soiling that goes on that Carolyn hasn't been used to in her life with that new baby. And I'm sure there's all other kinds of things that happen when she can walk into the room and there's, before she even checks the baby, there's a certain kind of an aroma. You remember that? Right? That can happen. Soiling, dirtiness, sin, aroma. Forgiveness brings cleansing. So take a look at this psalm tonight from Psalm 51. And did you notice David's prayer there? Washing shows up, cleansing shows up. Because this sin that he committed with Bathsheba has weighed heavily upon him. And no matter how many times he tried to justify what he did to be with her, and you know the story, I won't go through it now, but you can go back and read it. Justified himself, justified his actions, it got deeper and darker, and the stain spread and spread and spread until God had to put a stop to it because he had plans for David. So he brought Nathan to him to confront him with his sin. The only way that sin could be removed, the only way David would be able to find peace with his heart would be if God would clean him. Purge me with hyssop and I will be clean. Wash me and I will be whiter than snow. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. God's forgiveness cleans. Have you seen the advertising for some sort of cleaning spray that you can spray on surfaces that claims that it gives you 99.9% removal of the coronavirus on thing? I don't remember which one it is, but it's one of those sprays like Lysol, only it's not Lysol, but it's 99% effective in getting rid of the COVID virus on certain kinds of surfaces. God's forgiveness is better than that. Not 99.9%, but 100% complete. Naaman. In the Old Testament reading, leprosy. Sin spreads that way. It permeates every aspect of our lives, doesn't it? But God's gift to Naaman through that Israeli servant girl was to provide him a cure for his leprosy, but only the way that God would do it. And so Elisha, speaking on behalf of God, said to Naaman when he came, go and wash in the Jordan 7 times. Now Naaman thought, as we so easily can think too, well, any water could do, wouldn't it? It wasn't the Jordan water per se, but because God was attaching his word to that water, the promise of his word, that water for Naaman, that he would be clean if he dipped in there 7 times. And sure enough, he went and did what the Lord had commanded him to do through Elisha, and the word and the water worked. I mentioned already that we're going to have a baptism this Sunday for little Heidi Ruck. Now you would think that a newborn baby wouldn't have too many problems in this world yet, with the effects and the consequences of sin, but I'll tell you this, unless we do something, unless God does something, this child is destined to an eternity that you don't want to have anything to think about. Because sin leads to death. Every sin leads to death. She's no different. At however many weeks old, I think she might be a month old pretty soon, as the oldest member of this congregation, every sin needs forgiveness. God promises in baptism forgiveness of sins because he does the washing. That's why St. Paul could say in the Corinthian reading tonight, look at all these things, that if this kind of sinful activity is going on in your life, it will keep you out of the kingdom of God. But God washes you, he sanctifies you, he justifies you, and that's how you get in. That's how I got in. That's how you get in. God does the washing. He does the forgiving. He makes new life. He gives new life. And then the gospel reading to tie it all up. It's Holy Week. Jesus has just raised Lazarus from the dead. He'd been dead 4 days. The promise to Mary and Martha was that because Jesus was the resurrection and the life, anybody who died, who believing in him, would have life again. And Martha was the one who said, "Yes, Lord, I know in the resurrection on the last day he'll be raised." And Jesus then said, "I'm the resurrection and the life." And he raised Lazarus from the dead. So there was a, I suppose you could call it a post-funeral luncheon at Mary, Martha, and Lazarus' house. Martha served, we're told. And Mary came out with this pure nard that she poured over Jesus' feet. And the reaction was the aroma from that perfume filled the house. Jesus said that she was preparing him for his burial, but Judas thought it smelled rather bad, pun intended, because he could have taken that money and used it to feed the poor. That's another thing that happens with forgiveness. It cleans us up in such a way that God changes us to be people who offer a fragrant offering as we bring the gospel of God's love and forgiveness to those who are around us. The facet of forgiveness tonight is cleansing. You were washed. You were sanctified. You were justified when God made you his own dear child in baptism. You're washed. You're sanctified. You're justified when the word of absolution rings into your ears and down into your heart. You're washed. You're sanctified. You're justified every time you come to the Lord's table, and there, with bread and wine, our Lord gives you his own body and blood to forgive your sins, to strengthen your faith, to give you a new life again, a life that looks forward to the day of his coming, the life that looks forward to that grand and glorious day of resurrection when we'll find ourselves assembled at his table, clean as a whistle, no spot, no blemish, no wrinkle, because the one who loved us sanctified and washes us with his forgiveness. Forgiveness that's, well, it's rather remarkable because it meant the stain of his blood to cover us, to wash away our sin. The stain of his blood, as Paul will say, the blood of Jesus Christ, God's Son, cleanses us from all our sin. That's the facet of forgiveness that we find before us this evening. So let us rejoice in God's gift of love, his gift of forgiveness that washes us clean and gives us hope for the future as that forgiveness permeates through us to the world around us, that we become those who can go and, speaking those words of forgiveness, help others to become washed in Jesus as well. May God grant us that for his own name's sake. Amen. We join together now in singing the hymn, Rock of Ages.
But my sin, no respite, no,
Could my tears forever flow? All for sin could not atone. Thou must stay, and thou alone. Nothing in my hand I bring, simply to thy cross I cling. Naked come to thee for dress, thou blessed look to thee for grace. Bow I to the fountain fly, wash me, Savior, or I die. While I draw this living breath, when my life is closing down,
rise and pray. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the gift of divine peace and of pardon, with all our heart and with all our mind, let us pray to the Lord. For the Holy Christian Church here and scattered throughout the world, and for the proclamation of the gospel and the calling of all to faith, let us pray to the Lord. For this nation, for our cities and communities, and for the common welfare of us all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For seasonable weather and for the fruitfulness of the earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who labor, for those whose work is difficult or dangerous, and for all who travel, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those in need, for the hungry and homeless, for the widowed and orphaned, and for all those in prison, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the sick and dying, and for all those who care for them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Brennan Wool, who has been called by our congregation to come and proclaim the gospel among us, we pray, Lord, that you would assist him by your Holy Spirit to recognize the needs of our congregation and the welfare of your kingdom, and if it be your will, grant that he accept the call to serve among us. We also pray, Lord, this night for our brother Art Breithaupt, who is struggling with health issues, that you would visit him with your healing mercy and grant him strength of faith and trust in you. But we also pray, Lord, that you would bring healing to his body. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Finally, for these and for all our needs of body and soul, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed Lord, you have caused all holy scriptures to be written for our learning. Grant that we may so hear them, read, mark, learn, and take them to heart, that by the patience and comfort of your holy word, we may embrace and ever hold fast the blessed hope of everlasting life, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. I thank you, my Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have graciously kept me this day, and I pray that you would forgive me all my sins where I have done wrong, and graciously keep me this night. For into your hands I commend myself, my body and soul, and all things. Let your holy angel be with me, that the evil foe may have no power over me. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Almighty and merciful Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve us.
Amen. Amen.